Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's episode, we are talking all about whether hats can cause hair loss. It almost sounds like an old wives' tale, hats causing hair loss, but lots of old wives' tales actually have a hint of truth in them. Who knew that carrots can enhance your eyesight? But can wearing a hat every day actually cause or contribute to hair loss? We looked into this so you don't have to, and there's a lot to take in with these results. So let's just get straight into it. Things first, there isn't a completely straight cut answer to the question, can hats cause hair loss? Like most things, there's lots of elements to consider, and essentially the answer may depend on the person wearing the hat. The main issue here is that there hasn't been a huge amount of scientific research into this area. But there has been one notable study. A study by Gatherwright et al. 2013 used a combination of questionnaires, photographs and biological measures to investigate whether a range of factors were associated with increased male hair loss. The participants were all identical twins, and each person's data was compared with that of their twin in order to get a more accurate picture of the extent to which external factors outside of genetic predisposition contribute to hair loss or lack of. Identical twins are as close as you can possibly get to being genetically identical. Using them as participants made it easier to get a clear picture of the external factors being investigated without having to take into account of natural genetic differences. Interestingly, the study found not only that hat wearing did not seem to contribute to hair loss, but that daily hat use was in fact associated with decreased temporal hair loss. This is a genetic type of hair loss often referred to as the common receding hairline that many men will be familiar with. So there we go, we may as well just get to the shops and stock up on beanies, shall we? Not so fast! There is speculation that for people who are already genetically predisposed to hair loss, wearing a hat may actually speed up their hair loss. Here are a few of the main ideas that have been gathered on this. The first issue is hair pulling. It's argued that putting on or taking off a hat could pull hair that's already damaged and thinning, speeding up the process of hair loss. Secondly, wearing a hat could cause tension on the hair follicles. This is the most well-circulated argument, no pun intended. It's argued that wearing a very tight hat could cut off circulation to the hair follicles, meaning that they would be starved of oxygen and nutrients and would eventually die. However scary this might sound, the general consensus is that it's extremely unlikely, unless you're wearing literally the tightest hat in the world for a very long time. Hairstyles such as tight ponytails are much more likely to put your circulation at risk, causing something called traction alopecia. The main symptoms of the condition are redness, soreness, itching, scaling, blisters or bumps on the scalp, and inflammation of the hair follicles. Traction alopecia can be reversed, but if left alone, it can lead to hair follicles so scarred and damaged that they can't grow any new healthy hair. So perhaps this is something worth looking into if you often wear tight ponytails or dreadlocks. But it's important to remember that there is no real evidence to support a link between wearing hats and hair loss. Interestingly, smoking can affect circulation to the hair follicles. There has been a bit more scientific research to support these claims. If you're interested in this and other ways that smoking can cause hair loss, check out our videos linked here. We're going to put a link in the description down there. Lastly, there are a few indirect ways that wearing a hat may make hair loss look more dramatic than it actually is. The main one being hair breakage and split ends. These issues aren't directly hair loss related, but aesthetically, they could make your hair look a bit thinner. Wearing a hat daily could cause split ends and breakage, which definitely has the potential to make the hair look generally less healthy and could lead to the illusion of hair loss. If hair loss is something that's happening in your life at the moment, then we recommend that you take the It Really Works Vitamins 90-day challenge. It Really Works Vitamins are packed with 22 essential nutrients that help to encourage normal, healthy hair growth. We've got thousands of customers worldwide, and we've been featured in Men's Health, Men's Fitness, Shortlist Magazine and Forbes as the best nutrition innovation 2019 and 18. So you'll be joining thousands of guys worldwide that are on their It Really Works Vitamins 90-day challenge. The best thing about our brand is that if you don't love your results, then we'll give you a full refund with no questions asked. So check us out at itreallyworksvitamins.com and get free worldwide shipping. If you just want to find out more about us, or if you just want to ask questions that are specific about your hair, then just hit us up on Instagram. I've put the handle in here. We'll just answer lots of questions about hair. Lots of people send us pictures. They ask just anything. We've heard it all and we've seen it all. So please do message us there, or just send us a comment or a message here on YouTube. Okay, so there we have the reasons that wearing a hat may contribute to hair loss, but it's important to take these with a pinch of salt because there isn't a huge amount of scientific evidence showing a link between wearing a hat and hair loss. So where did this myth come from, you may ask? Well, there are a few possibilities. The biggest issue is probably the circulation of the idea through word of mouth and scaremongering in the media. For example, this frankly terrifying statement appeared in a 2015 GQ article. Guys that are wearing a hat all the time are creating their own male pattern baldness. They're not allowing the sweat glands to breathe, and they're clogging the follicles, which prevents hair growth. You need oxygen in order to produce the oils that help your hair to grow. However, in an interview with the Huffington Post, Dr. Alan Bowman, a board-certified hair restoration physician, completely debunked this statement and said it was 100% false. Dr. Bowman went on to explain that male pattern hair loss is hereditary and completely caused by hormones. So we'll explain this in a little bit more detail a bit later on. There are also a few physical signs that cause people to jump to the conclusion that hair loss is caused by wearing hats. For example, regular hat wearers often notice hair left inside their hat after wearing it for a few hours in the day. And understandably, they assume that this is evidence enough that their hat has caused hair loss. However, this is not the case. It's completely normal to lose up to 100 strands of hair each day. And it's just that when you're wearing a hat, these strands are being collected. And so it can look quite alarming, but it's only because we don't usually notice that our hair is falling out every day. Secondly, many people begin to start noticing hair loss when they start wearing a hat, and they start wearing a hat in an effort to conceal it. And as a result, when their genetic hair loss starts to accelerate or worsen, it's quite a natural conclusion to jump to that the hat has speeded up their hair loss, when in reality, it may just be the natural progression of male or female pattern baldness. And so correlation does not equal cause. Guys, if you are finding this video useful, we'd be so grateful if you would like to subscribe. We have lots and lots of videos coming out all about how to keep your hair thick and healthy and strong and to fight hair loss. So please subscribe, and please remember to hit the notification bell because YouTube often won't tell you when our latest video has come out. So please subscribe. Also, feel free to DM us at any time on Instagram. Our handle is here. Lots of people also send pictures of their hair. They ask lots of really in-depth questions, and we're always happy to help. So feel free to comment here or follow us on Instagram and DM us and let us know what you think. Also, if you have any interesting bits of feedback or any type of questions that you think that we've not yet answered, please do message us and let us know. We're always interested in finding out about what other people want to find out about and want to learn about to do with hair care and hair loss. Okay, so getting back to the link between wearing a hat and hair loss. Finally, there is the phenomenon known as hat head. Hat head can create the illusion of thinner or more sparse hair, even if this just isn't the case. It's an extremely common problem when wearing a hat. And if you haven't experienced it yourself, then you've probably seen it on some other poor soul. When the hair is pushed in unnatural directions by a hat, it may look flat or particularly thin in some areas when the hat is removed. So this can be mistaken for a sign of hair loss, when in reality, it's simply that the hair isn't sitting in its natural or preferred position. Essentially, hair loss is ultimately down to genetic factors, although the exact science of this isn't well known. It's generally thought that male pattern baldness is the result of the hair's growth phase becoming shorter, and the time between the shedding of a hair and a new growth phase becoming longer. Also, the hormone DHT, which is a product of the breakdown of testosterone, shrinks the hair follicles, preventing hair from growing healthily. When the follicles begin to miniaturize, the hair that they produce becomes weaker and thinner over time, before ceasing to produce any hair at all. Unfortunately, hair loss is extremely common, and the British National Health Service points out that 50% of men, by the time they're 50, will experience some degree of hair loss. And in fact, the International Society of Hair Restoration Surgery reports that 40% of men will experience hair loss by the time they turn 35. So you're certainly not alone if hair loss is something that you're struggling with. And male pattern baldness often runs in families, so if members of your family have hair loss, it's extremely likely that you'll inherit this condition too. Key symptoms of genetic hair loss include a receding hairline. That's a hairline in the shape of an M, or bald patches or thinning hair on the top of the head. So the chances are that your hair loss has much more to do with your genetic makeup rather than your hat-wearing habits. But we also do know that hair loss is multifactorial, so there are lots of things that can contribute to hair loss. Granted, genetics may be having the bulk to say in the issue, but that doesn't necessarily mean that there's nothing you can do about it. There are a whole load of lifestyle factors that you can control that can slow down pattern baldness. A few examples of lifestyle factors that can contribute to hair loss are stress, vitamin deficiencies, which we can help with, as well as alcohol use, not getting enough exercise, junk food, and drugs, as well as smoking. So evidently, lifestyle can contribute to hair loss at least a little bit. And if each of these factors combined with wearing a tight hat regularly do cause a bit of extra hair loss, you may end up with a more noticeable issue. So the question of whether hats can cause hair loss is a little bit up for debate. But get this, there is also some evidence that wearing a hat can improve your hair growth. Wearing a hat can be invaluable in protecting your hair from the elements. And this can be the case in both winter and summer. In winter, especially if you go outside with wet hair, it's highly beneficial to protect your strands from the cold, as wet hair can become weak and prone to breakage, especially in wintry conditions. On the flip side, in summer, it can be beneficial to wear a hat, not only for general health and to reduce the risk of sunstroke, but to protect your hair and scalp from UV rays, preventing the heat from drying out your hair or burning your skin. In fact, wearing a hat in summer is absolutely vital and far outweighs the tiny risk of your hat increasing hair loss. Exposure to UV rays can cause a whole host of skin issues, including discoloration, freckles, wrinkles, premature aging, and not to mention skin cancer. So don't throw away your baseball cap just on misinformation and rumours. Okay, so let's wrap up on everything that we've covered so far. First of all, in theory, regularly wearing a very tight hat could contribute in a small way to hair loss. However, the risk really isn't worth worrying about, and in fact, the elements that your hat is protecting you from could be posing a much greater risk to hair loss. This could be an explanation for the findings on twins in the study that we mentioned earlier, in which hat wearers actually had less hair loss than non-hat wearers, but more research is needed in order to confirm a link. Having said that, due to the current lack of research, it can't be confirmed that wearing a hat will absolutely not cause hair loss either. So if you do feel that your hat wearing habits are impacting your hair follicles, what can you do? Well, there are a few things that you can easily try. Firstly, if you don't want to stop wearing hats altogether, you could choose a looser style to avoid unnecessary tension causing stress on your hair follicles. If you have long hair, maybe try not to combine wearing your hat with regular tight hairstyles. Alternatively, you could simply reduce how often you wear a hat. Perhaps save it for cold days or when you need to protect your hair from the sun. And if you think hat head is something that you're dealing with, then we definitely have a few tips and tricks to stop this from happening. First of all, make sure that your hair has completely dried before putting your hat on if possible, as allowing it to set underneath can really exacerbate the appearance of hat head, and it makes it much, much more difficult to sort out. Secondly, choose a hat that has a smoothing material on the inside rather than a kind of frizzy, rough material. But most of all, don't stress out about it, because ironically, stressing out about whether your hat is causing hair loss is actually going to cause much more hair loss than the hat itself. Another subject that we just want to quickly touch upon before we go is another type of hat that we haven't considered so far, and these are helmets. Many of us wear helmets in our daily lives. Perhaps you're a cyclist or a motorcyclist, or maybe you wear one for work every day. But have you ever thought about how your headwear may be affecting your scalp and your hair health? Especially if hair loss is something that you're already dealing with, or if it runs in your family, this might be a concern for you. So be rest assured that there isn't too much to worry about. As with regular hats, there's no scientific evidence backing up a link between wearing a helmet and hair loss. Although there has been some speculation that there is a link between helmets and hair loss, this isn't something worth stressing out about, but we do have a few top tips for you and can show you how to prevent your hair from being damaged by your helmet. First of all, make sure to keep your helmet clean. So what you don't want is for your scalp to become dirty, and this could lead to infection, which could be detrimental to the health of your hair. It's important to note that this could also apply to any other type of headwear, so it's important to keep your hats clean as well, so remember to regularly wash them, and in your helmet use an antibacterial spray. It's also really important to make sure that you're wearing the right size of helmet, because if it's too big or too small, your hair could be pulled out at the root. And this could ultimately lead to traction alopecia, which we mentioned a little bit earlier in the video. So what do you think? Do you have any personal experience of finding that hair loss has been worsened by wearing a hat, or the other way around, do you feel that your hat is protecting you from hair loss? So feel free to comment below. Also message us on Instagram, we're always interested. And if you have any other feedback on this video or any particular questions that you would like us to answer in some of our next videos, just message us or drop a comment here. We're always interested in finding out what our viewers would like to see. So please do let us know. Also remember, if you're struggling with hair loss, then It Really Works Vitamins is here to help. As I mentioned earlier, It Really Works Vitamins are packed with 22 essential nutrients that help to keep your hair healthy and strong. We offer free worldwide shipping. We've been featured in Men's Health, Men's Fitness, Forbes and Shortlist Magazine as the best hair regrowth product for men. Yay! So hit us up, we offer free worldwide shipping in discreet packaging. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, guys. Remember that It Really Works Vitamins are here to help. If you're dealing with hair loss at the moment, then check us out. And we've also just put a discount code here, which is applicable to subscription orders as well, if you would like to try us out. Before I forget to mention, if you've seen one or two or three of our videos and you've been looking around on our channel but you've not yet hit the subscribe button, then please do subscribe. We've got lots of videos coming out all about how to keep your hair thick and healthy and to slow down hair loss. So hit subscribe and you'll never miss out on any of our content. And don't forget to hit the bell, because YouTube doesn't actually doesn't tell people when videos come out anymore. So it's kind of changed. Also, feel free to follow us on Instagram so you'll never miss out on when our videos go live. We look forward to seeing you next time and have a fantastic day as always. Bye for now.